The grace that saves us, the grace that justifies us, is the same grace that is sanctifying us.
And also in the soteriological ministry of the Holy Spirit, we also have part there,
and
in preaching the gospel.
Oh, yes. Our part. In preaching the gospel, that our part is only to preach.
Mm.
But the conversion is fully the work of the Holy Spirit.
But it is possible, Basel, nga, without the preaching of the gospel, there must be a, there will be a conviction of the Holy Spirit.
Oh, lots of it. There are lots of it in the Bible. There are lots of conversion even without preaching the gospel. Cornelius. Okay. And some example, our Muslim brothers, Hindu brothers and sisters, who
were like preaching, huh?
No preaching. They just have a dream. They only have a dream. And in that dream, they talk to Jesus. And from there, they were converted. The next day, when they wake up, they are already converted as a Christian. But this conversion needs to be confirmed and to be followed up. Kasi, my classmate, during my PhD, Devi Mata, she was an Indian princess. Her father was a priest, Hindu priest. So there was no possibility for her to be converted to Christianity. Because her father was an Hindu priest in the state of Assam. Assam. But one day, one night, Devi Mata dreamed that the Lord Jesus Christ was talking to him, to her. And from there, she believed. But Devi Mata, after 1 week, went to a small Presbyterian church in the state of Assam and looked for a pastor. And the pastor explained to her about salvation. So it needs to be confirmed, that needs to be followed.
So, sir, in that justification case, there must be presupposition of judicial intervention of God to a sinner?
Always. The presupposition is always that one. It's always an intervention of God, judicially, especially in the aspect of justification. Because justification is judicial, or it is what? A legal word. It is a legal terminology. It is a courtroom language. Hey! Break 5 minutes.
Ah.